fathers said it exactly right, Wayne. They said, united we stand and divided we fall. Sir Winston Churchill, in 1941, in a radio speech, said, and I'd like to read it verbatim, we shall not fail or falter. We shall not weaken or tire. Neither the sudden shock of battle nor the long-drawn trials of vigilance and I'm trying to do it without my glasses. The long-drawn trials of vigilance and exertion will wear us down. Give us the tools and we will finish the job. Well, I say to each of you here tonight that we have the tools because we have the support of two-thirds of the people of this great commonwealth as evidenced by our most recent survey, USA, and the Keep polls. We take surveys constantly. It's very important to know what the people are thinking. It's very important to know that we're doing what we ought to be doing to satisfy the people. And what the people are telling us is that they want the right to elect their representatives, and they expect their representatives to be able to communicate with them. They do not expect their representatives to be controlled by anyone else. And you and I both know that what has happened in this situation that we've just gone through is that even though we were promised that we would have a fair hearing before the House and the Senate, we got a fair hearing before the House, but we did not get a fair hearing before the Senate. There's no way that you can ever think that fairness means presenting it only to a percent of the Senate less than half. That's not fairness. So because of that, there are a number of people that have done the wrong thing in this whole situation. It really is like a third world dictatorship.